Hello and welcome to Let's Play Old Games and welcome back to Motorsport Manager. We are in Season 7 with Wellen Racing. We have done 10 races. This is easily our best season so far. We have won the last 3 races in a row with Surikov, Milan, Belgium and the US Grand Prix in Phoenix. So 3 in a row. The last one was completely unexpected. And yeah, so the next race is in Canada in 17 days. So let's read the mail. Okay, car condition update. Way things work now. Hey boss, I've had a bit of an epiphany. I'm actually pretty damn good. I think we've had a whole working relationship the wrong way around. You're lucky to have me here. I deserve more respect. Oh, and if we get around to renegotiating contracts, I'll be expecting the kind of salary I deserve. Yep, ego has completely blown out of proportion here. Even the chairman's unhappy. Desired earnings, $500,000. Yeah, I'm already giving you more than $500,000. Seriously, the moment they get slightly better, their heads become enormous. Okay. Steinman was by the bit of disaster finishing. What's your analysis? Okay, I'm just kissing up to Becker just in case we have to, you know, if Surikov gets too big for his boots. In fact, why don't we tell her to scout Becker? Okay, where is Pascal Becker? Is he not that good? Or is he not available? Hashimoto's sitting on the sideline. Smoothness isn't good with Hashimoto, okay. Sharp, Panthers, Rossini. Where is Becker? Steinman. Okay, there he is. Yeah, scout him, please. In fact, scout the three. Yeah, scout all three of these Steinman drivers. They are sort of the right age. And maybe money is a little more than I would like, but okay, and let's see if we have any more good drivers, because Surikov is just getting too arrogant now for my liking. Lipponen is a bit old now. Sharp is getting a lot of money. He can't afford Sharp. Hashimoto's main problem is the smoothness. Molly Fox is pretty good. No, adaptability is bad. Balcazar. Siri's unemployed. How much does she want? Siri hasn't improved. Yeah, she wanted to leave. What could have done? Harry Chapman is okay. He's too old now. 37. Ong Liao. Cornering, come on, cornering is kinda important, guys. Persani, remember Persani? Yeah, he hasn't improved either. How old is he these days? 36. Okay, Matilda Fig. She seems okay, but they are getting a lot of money. No, we'll stick with our policy of giving sort of untapped younger drivers a chance. Okay, so the 17-year-old, scout him as well. He could be useful. Yeah, if Surikov decides to leave. Okay, how long before we have to negotiate his contract? Another 2 years and a bit, so he should be fine. He'll forget about it. He'll lose a couple of races and he'll be back down to earth. Meanwhile, at the HQ, what I wanted to see was What helps the drivers improve? Handling. Handling and lock component suspension gives your drivers the chance to improve their cornering and smoothness. Cornering and smoothness. So Marlene here, she needs cornering, braking, overtaking, fitness. She needs to improve all of this. Bad at curse. Bad at curse. Yeah, how do we improve drivers? I mean, is it just like normal, it just happens? I wanted to see where it shows like how much they improve per race or something like that. Depends on their age. So she's only 22, so that should be useful. Anyway, so we were looking at the HQ. So design center, factory, brakes, helps with their braking, obviously. Development improves their cornering and smoothness. So we should look at getting the handling and development center upgraded. 12 million. Simulator improves their adaptability and consistency. Okay, telemetry center improves their smoothness. So smoothness. So telemetry and handling improves their smoothness. Test track improves their cornering and overtaking. Okay, so basically we have to upgrade everything. So if we want to improve smoothness, we'll have to go handling and telemetry center. Anyway, let's continue. Car repair is complete. And sponsors. Okay, let's see the sponsor. Oh, we need money badly. Cortez, we'll take Cortez because 500,000. Okay, hang on, let's just wait. No, it's not panic. We need a lot of money per race. New world started. New world has begun over at the Global Motors. Time is about Cortez tires. Okay, we'll just select the Cortez maybe. We haven't had any here. We need somebody paying a lot of per race. Okay, Joko Games, definitely. We'll probably select Cortez as well. But let's go and vote for. Okay, new world has begun. Let's have Cortez tires. Will benefit teams easy on the tires. Okay, I'll vote for them. Yeah, easy win. Approved. Tires wins. Water has been changed and there will be a new players. Okay. Hey, our factory staff isn't doing anything. Okay, let's see what they're doing. Yeah, they don't really have much to do unless we make new parts, which we are not doing right now. Trying to save money here. Don't know, maybe this could be a bad idea, but so far we have been doing well. So SEP Oil gives us 6.5 million upfront. Should we take the upfront money? Kashima gives us 300,000. I'll take Cortez because 400 grand per race. 400 or 500? 400. And for see, 400, 400, and 250. So we're making over a million just by these three. We should probably switch over to. Let's go to the finances and switch over to fat stacks. This will reduce our income a bit, but still 800,000 per race. Prepared a brief report on the next calendar. 29 lap race, 3.39 miles, 122. Likely to be some rain. Yes. Now, Surikov is doing so well. We should be happy, but he's becoming a bit of an arrogant guy. So, okay. So, yeah, these guys were paying us a lot of money. One of these, I think 6.5 million upfront. I would prefer if one of these guys gave us that kind of money. Anyway, so if we go back to the homepage, our sponsors are still not that great. Car is still only 7th. We got an achievement, struck gold. Don't know what that means. A rumor of a rift have emerged from within the halls of Ellen's HQ after Surikov overheard his own chairman criticizing his driving skills. Nikolai was fuming, said a source within the team. The chairman was saying all sorts. He's useless, he couldn't drive his way out of a car price, got worse overtaking skills than my mom. What the hell is wrong with these people? I mean, this doesn't make sense. He's won the last three races. Why would the chairman criticize him now of all? It's just idiotic. Yeah, I could understand the ego part. That made sense. He won three races in a row, so ego going large was understandable. But why is the chairman criticizing him now? Okay, Cristiano. He improves the marketability. Okay, good. Okay, let's see what she has on Rictigraph. Feedback is poor. And what about focus? Is he married to something? Addictive personality. Addictive to what? He's also pretty good. And he's making 852. He's getting a lot of bonuses though. Surikov is a bit easier to handle. Ah, this is annoying. Okay, let's continue. So they're saying there's chance of rain. We'll go with our usual 9th or above. Because we can't expect it. If we had something in between, like 4th or 5th, that would have been better. But unfortunately, we don't. Yeah, we'll go with an even split here. Medium, high tire wear, high fuel burn. Okay, got it. Normally we go with the yellow soft tire here and try to do two stints on that one stop, because that is where our advantage is, smoothness on the tires. Chairman has lost his happiness for no reason. Makes no sense. He should have been happy. He should have been giving bonuses to that guy, treating him, giving him like a private party or something. Three wins in a row and you criticize that guy. It doesn't make sense at all. Yeah, even Marlene is up to 16 now. Okay. Okay, practice is dry, so 16 to 18. So this is 29 laps, so we can theoretically do two stints on these. Okay. A bit of downforce, I suppose. Maybe a bit more oversteer here. And slightly longer gearing. Not sure, I'm just guesswork here. Okay, downforce a bit here, handling a bit on the oversteer side, and let's leave the gearing in the middle. Okay, as always, you can skip practice if you like. I'll put the timestamps in the description and the comment section for the three sessions. Okay, let's go for some race setup first, as we always do. Yep. Okay, gear ratios are just right. Okay, good. So he's happy with slightly longer ratios, and she's also happy with like just in the middle. How's the downforce and the handling? More angle, okay. So more downforce needed. Okay, we'll sort it out, no worries. Handling isn't responsive enough. Can we do something about that? Okay, we'll do something. More stability through the corner. So more understeer, I think, is what they're asking for. Okay, they should get to level 3 by the time they come back. Okay, handling is very poor as expected. Downforce is quite bad. Okay, so handling is poor, so we can go very high on the downforce, something like this. Handling will go completely the other side, and gearing will go long. Maybe not that long. Okay, start work on the quali. So his speed balance is great, so I think we got it right with him. Yeah. Okay, so downforce. Okay, handling. Perhaps here. And bit more downforce, probably not that much more. Okay, I think this should be better. Should get to level 3s here. Okay, no rain expected in practice. Okay, good. Aero is way better. Aero is feeling much nicer. Good, good. Okay, handling is much better. How is the gearing? Okay, he seems to be really happy with the handling. Okay, speed balance is better. Okay, excellent. Okay, he has three grades and she has excellence and two grades, so nearly there. Now the question is, do we go more downforce? Might be too much on the gearing. Okay, let's see what happens here. Trying to get the downforce sorted. If the okay with him, a tiny bit more on the gear, on the downforce. Handling, we could probably come back a bit. Okay, let's see what happens here. They should hit level 3 on the way back. Yeah. Okay, speed balance is worse, but the handling is better. No, the downforce is better. Where was the speed balance before? So we have to come back. And handling. Not much difference here. See, this is great. This is good. Okay, this should be better, I think. Now she had good downforce, right? Now it's good right now. It was excellent before. No, it was great before. This was great. So we need to reduce the downforce. Hopefully this is better. With the gearing, I'm not so sure. Okay, just go out if you can. Only 24 seconds. She can get out of the pits. She'll be able to go and come back. Yep. If not, we'll select the one which is sort of the best anyway. Okay, I think this is better. Okay, 5 and 11 is good. Okay, so Saturday is also dry, which is not good. I think it gets wet afterwards, maybe. Anyway, we'll just go out, set a lap, try to get two attempts. Yeah, Surikov, cool. Cristiano. Once again, if they can get inside the top 9, at least one of them, I think it'll be a decent effort. Luckily for us, Surikov has another 2 years on his contract. 1.8 off the pace. 2.3 off the pace. Okay, that is pretty slow. The Rossinis are fast again. They're faster than the Steinmans today. Both of them are outside the... Yeah, we haven't built many parts. We've only done like the gearbox. So it's sort of understandable. We haven't improved them much. Okay, let's send this guy out first this time. Let's switch over. Surikov really needs to come back down to earth, otherwise he won't be able to do a good. Okay, dry. We really need an improvement here. Surikov is not improving. No improvement, sadly. So Becker, De Graaf, Balcazar, Sharp. 1, 2, 3, 4 are the same. Then we have Bergman, Fischer, Lipponen and Bergman. So Lipponen is Panther. Not going to plan here. I wanted one of them inside the top 9. So we'll do the same thing. We'll go long and do a one stop. Hopefully they won't lose too many places at the start. Okay, so start is dry, although it looks like there's clouds, so it could get wet, I suppose. They said 40% chance of rain. No rain, no rain. Okay, so go with soft. Now what tire should we start on? See, he's only getting 12 to 14, so he'll get 10 probably. He will struggle to do two stints, one stop, so we'll have to put him on the soft. Now Surikov might be a bit smoother. 14, so he'll be just about able to get 14. And he can, so even if he, say, if he gets 12, we can still do 17 on these, so he should be fine. So he can start on the soft. You can push a bit. You can just push for one lap. We won't push on the fuel. We'll see what the fuel situation is. Yeah, I don't expect to finish well here. I'd say 5 to 6 would be the best we can expect. Okay, good start. Good start, Surikov. Nice, nice. Even past the Rossini. Obviously, they'll murder us soon. Yep. Because anybody on the Ultras will just breeze past. Okay. How is the fuel situation? Okay, push on the fuel. Okay, good job. Good job, Surikov. I'm liking this. Do not crash, people. And where is Cristiano? He's actually ahead of people on... Okay, careful, careful. He's doing a decent job too. Okay, temperatures are fine, fuel is fine, keep pushing. Surikov is up to 6 here, ahead of Lipponen. Okay, so let's go back to Surikov. Yeah, Lipponen could be a problem. Bergman and Lipponen are the same team, right? No, Bergman is Kitano, Lipponen is Panther. Okay, I think this is good. Ease up on the tires. You can push a bit more, Cristiano. But see, behind Surikov... Okay, Surikov has dropped behind Lipponen. Okay, anyway, behind Surikov is De Wolf, Vercruci, Navarro. They're all on Ultras. I'm not worried about Navarro because he might have to pit again very soon. But De Wolf and Vercruci are on much faster tires, the Ultrasofts. If they can hang on for another 2 laps ahead, good job, good job. Okay, keep going, keep going. Try and not fall. See, Navarro is pitting. Get past Navarro, get past Navarro. Blah. Okay, careful. Ease up on the fuel. We pushed a bit. Ease up on the tires. So he's doing fine in 9th, 11th. Surikov is in 7th, which is alright, I guess. If he can hold off these two for a bit, they'll pit in about 2 to 3 laps anyway. Because these Ultras, they fall off the cliff very quickly. And we have to remember, Surikov needs to get 14 laps out of these tires. Okay, push. Okay, see, De Wolf, no, Vercruci has gone past De Wolf. Now, she, is that a she or a he? I'm not sure. Okay, let's see. Vercruci is a guy. Surikov is a guy, of course. Okay, Cristiano, push. Surikov might struggle to get the 14, but like I said, we could do 12 and then go to the end. Okay, careful. Okay, see, they have used up their tires. They have to pit now. And 7, where is... Okay, Balcazar. Okay, Balcazar has already pitted. Okay. Okay, this is fine, Surikov. This is fine. I like this. Okay, you are up to 9. 8, actually. Good. Keep pushing, keep pushing. 7 and 8. Realistically, we could probably squeeze one or two places, maybe get ahead of Lipponen, maybe Bergman. But Beckers and Rossini, I mean the Steinmans and the Rossinis, they are just too fast. So at best, we could get 5, 6, maybe 6, 7 is more realistic. See, De Graaf has pitted and still come out in front of us. No, Becker. So they have a pit stop in hand over us. Yeah, so... Yeah, 6 or 7, 5 or 6, that's about it really. Now, De Graaf is behind me. De Graaf is probably going to the end. I don't think they can go to the end. No, I don't think so. Yeah, Surikov will get 11 laps, 12 laps. This is lap 11, he'll be able to do another lap, I suppose. We'll just ease off a bit, just to make sure we get the next lap in. Cristiano is up to 7, Surikov is up to 5. Yeah, between 5 and 7 is what we can expect, and that would be a good result in these conditions, unless it rains, which I don't think it does. Okay, Surikov can pit this lap. We'll go. Can we do another stint? No, not realistic. Okay, we'll try and do something I've seen in the... So when he's going into the pits, we just back up completely. Save a tiny bit of fuel, I suppose. Okay, and they made a mistake. Bloody idiots. Now, the fifth is looking unlikely with that mistake. We'll just push a bit on the tires for a bit. See, Vercruci and those people, Bergman, Fischer, they were behind Surikov, so that pit stop made sure they went ahead. It's kind of ruined it for him. Now, can you do something? Okay, actually, he will pit you now. He's only managed 14 laps. Can he do 16 now on these tires? Yeah, he's actually struggling to even get the softs done. Yeah, come on buddy, you are probably our hope now. At least the stop went fine. He's still behind Surikov though. So this did not actually go to plan. Even without the mistake, with the mistake, I was expecting him to come out in front of Surikov. Yeah, he might actually struggle to get to the end on these tires. Okay, careful, careful. He has got a lot of people behind him. Okay, Fisher is pitting. Yeah, 1-2-4 is like out of question. Probably Lipponen will also. Maybe the best we can expect is 6. See, I'm hoping Bergman and Vercruci will pit again so we can get up to 6 and 7. But that's about it. But Bergman is a long way ahead of Christianos. He might actually come out in front even when he pits. Because he'll come out on ultras, and even if he comes behind us, he might be able to catch up and get past on track. I don't know how much that pit stop affected. Maybe one place we could have gained. Okay, Vercruci has a problem. Okay, Canada, no crashes, nobody having issues, which is a bit strange. Okay, Vercruci is pitting. So we'll get past Vercruci. And Bergman will probably pit next lap. His tires are almost gone. Yep, he's in the pits. He has got a very long neck. So we should get ahead of him. But he will come out on the ultras, so. Yeah, he's only 4 seconds behind. He's come out on the super soft, so they probably did not have spare ultras left. Okay, Cristiano, just push a bit. I think you can push on the tires as well. Just make sure we get 6 and 7. See, we are 50 seconds behind the leader, so Sharp and De Graaf, they can pit and they'll still come out comfortably in front. So Becker looks like in position to win the race here. Yeah, Becker and Balcazar are like better placed. Balcazar probably. Not Balcazar, Becker. Definitely Becker. De Graaf can't go to the end. The longer he stays out, the worse it'll be. And Lipponen is like comfortably in between everybody, so he'll hold on to 5 quite easily. And yeah, we should hopefully hold on to 6 and 7, although Bergman is probably going to get past at least one of our cars, maybe even both. See, De Graaf has gone on to the Ultras now. Okay, I think you can back up on the tires. We still need to get these to the end. So lap 26, 27, 28, 29. So he needs to get 3 laps. We'll just make sure we can conserve this. I think Bergman should get past him. Yeah, Bergman is all over him. So this has gone sort of as expected. Even Surikov is struggling on the tires. Okay, this is the final lap. Okay, let's see Cristiano if you can hold up this guy. Somebody has already finished. Becker, Sharp, De Graaf, Balcazar. Okay, so sort of as we expected. Okay, managed to hold off Bergman. 6 and 7. Not great, but I guess we can't win every race, can we? Yeah, sort of predictable result. Like, this is sort of where we are pace wise. Those last 3 races, they were a bit surprising. Okay, we picked up 14 points. Still, he's now behind Becker. Long way behind. So, yeah, obviously, I wasn't expecting him to win the drivers. And the Rossinis are obviously catching up. So, we are sort of looking at Panther here. We are comfortably ahead of Panther, 120 clear. Yeah, third should be easy. If we drop third from here, it'll be bad. Five races to go. They'll need to get 25 at least per race and expect us not to score any points. Otherwise, we are, but with the Rossinis and the Steinmans much quicker, I don't expect Panther to win anything or get a lot of points unless all 4 of them are taken out or something. Okay, morale is high for all 3 of them. Boss is also happy. We got a million in the bag. Okay, this is about... See, everybody's happy with this result, even the boss. Surikov's ego should also deflate a little bit. Okay, so that was Canada. Nothing special there. And the next up is Singapore, my least favorite race. But at least it's wet, so maybe there's something we can do. Okay, anyway. Okay, so I'll see you for the Singapore Grand Prix.